Welcome to my group.
How are you?
Hi, Alicia.
Very good. And welcome to this online meeting with Alicia, finance expert. Meet Vibhu Sharma.
Hi.
Alicia. Hi, guys. I'm very glad that we meet finally because we know each other from only. Hi.
Yeah. I've been trying to connect with you for like more than a month.
Yes, we were looking for a date to talk. So I'm a financial planner from Germany. So actually I'm kind of a broker. That means that we can work with all financial and insurance tools.
Hello everybody, this is Alica Aswani, your support for financial matters in Germany.
60 degrees in all financial matters. And I decided to focus only on expats. So let's say you move to Germany because you find this amazing job there, or you just want to become a freelancer there. So you would be my customer. So I would support you opening a bank account, opening the insurances that you need, the mandatory insurances in Germany, like health insurance and so on. And later on, if you want to stay in Germany, of course, then there are topics like pension, buying a real estate, you know, everything what makes your money grow.
Amazing. It's very interesting.
I'm Indian, so I have like a big Indian family. And my surname Aswani, I think from Mumbai.
Very interesting. It feels like that we are talking to a family member in Germany.
Yes. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Feels the same. You know, because we have the same background, or, you know, similar culture. So I agree with that.
Right. And one more question. Like, if someone from India try to settle in Germany, what are the basic steps? Like, if a student is there and he is trying to get education, loan or some settlement into Germany. So how he should start?
Mm-hmm. It's a good question. So the first steps to do to make it in Germany, that means, for example, the loan, the student loan, most of the loans are made from India, they're not German loans.
Okay.
So it's important that you, as Indian citizen, that you have like a reason to come, that you come for with a job or with the plans. So everything is much easier. So once you are in Germany, the basic is the inscription. You have to be inscribed into the as German, you know, citizen or visitor, because once you live in Germany, you're a citizen. You're not like German, but you're a citizen of Germany. So you have to inscribe yourself, and then you get a tax number. So everyone in Germany has a tax number. This is super important. And then the health insurance, because it's mandatory in Germany to be health insured for students, for employees, even for housewives that don't work, it's mandatory. So here it's like a big, here's a lot of consultation needed, you know. Which one is the right health insurance, a private or a state one?
Insurance is kind of a big deal, you know. A country wants you to have insurance before you visit there. Maybe you can't come back and you don't have money, you declare bankruptcy over there. So to get through that issues, insurance is like very important. And I did research also in, you know, German insurance and finance, and it is very, very complicated because, you know, if some kind of a language we know is comparable to English, okay, it's very different, and mostly all the documents are German based, so translation is also very hard to find, and, you know, to get a kind of a relevancy and you know, proper exposure of things, you need to be educated in German language, or at least so what do you specially study German language? I was looking at your profile, Alicia. You also visited Africa and you visited India, so you are like a global person, huh?
So the first point is so correct. That's a big problem in Germany, because Germany seems very international, and we have so many international people coming every year. It's amazing, and this is actually what makes the country great. And I think it's very good that fresh people come to the country to make the country a bit more modern, because as you said, everything is in German, because I think it's very old school still Germany. And people have to know that even if it's very international and we welcome international people, for example, all details, back details, state documents, they're all in German.
I just wanted to ask about what about the startup eco culture over in Germany. Like in India, we can see a lot of people are starting their own startups. A lot of new concepts can be seen. Companies like Oyo, and there are quite a few unicorn startups also here in India right now. So what's about the startup culture in Germany? Like are the startups emerging there? Because you are also in the finance sectors, so like, do you help startups and businesses to get money also?
That's a good question. That's a good point what you're saying. Startups in Germany. Germany is like a culture of employees, because like you have these amazing companies in Germany, like Mercedes, Porsche, Bayersdorf, like all these great companies. So I think it's more like an employee culture, where people study hard. So Indians and Germans have that in common, that they study really hard to get like a good job. Yep. And they are okay not being freelancer. For example, in the US, it's so different. Everybody aims for being an entrepreneur. Yep. In Germany, it's not like that actually, and it's nothing bad about. So I think that the startup thing, it's a very new generation thing. And I'm very happy when expats do the steps to become an entrepreneur in Germany. That's so amazing.
So are there special tax benefits to, start a business in Germany? Like if somebody wants to, somebody has a startup idea. So if there can be any additional benefit, like, if they can get additional funding or tax benefit if they do business in Germany?
Well, you have if you present the business idea, you can to the state, for example, you can get like support to build up your business or like loan. So this is possible. But this you really need if you open like a restaurant or something with employees. How I started for €0. I just look, you offer a service. Uh-huh. And then you find customers, and then you don't need actually money or funds. And then once you earn money, or once you have revenue, you can, of course, go to a tax advisor, and there are tax benefits, of course, because you can present all the costs that you had as tax benefits. So for sure, it's very something very good for taxes being independent. But you can start with €0 in Germany. It's very easy, and I love to motivate like young people to try it, because they can always go back to the jobs. But really, funds you need if you're opening a big company, like with employers and so. And I think young people should start, from scratch with not much cost, so they can, it's not a burden for them. We always worked.
And it was beautiful talking to you, Alica.
Thank you.
And let's see when we are going to do this again.
Yeah, maybe we play a chess game also.
Any last message for our LinkedIn audience, Alica?
Just be happy, save money, invest money, and invest in yourself.
And go to Germany. Even COVID can't stop Germany.
Exactly.
That's a big thing. That's a huge thing, man.
Perfect, guys. And if you are going to Germany and if you have any financial problem, she's the person.
Exactly. Expat power in Germany.
So thank you, Alica. It was wonderful talking to you. Thank you so much.
Same. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the interest. Really. It's nice to be interviewed by India.
It's very cool. End with a namaste.
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 Bye, Alica.